What up, Doe Connors? I got some good news and I got some bad news. The good news is that the bad news is very quick, and that is World Tournament is this weekend. Both versions are having World Tournament at the same exact time. This is the first time in Dokkan history, I think, that both versions are on the same World Tournament, even though ours is numbered 52 and JP's is number 54. It's the same, like, characters, and it's the same LR and whatnot. So this is going to be your preview for the upcoming World Tournament. 50 easy Dragonstones are up for grabs. I say easy because, unlike actual competitive World Tournament, you don't have to be racing against anybody else. All of the missions that you need to do to get Dragonstones can be done at your own pace. While it is somewhat time-consuming, you have 2 to 3 days to take care of this all weekend, and you don't have to worry about other people breathing down your neck. If you're trying to gun for, like, the top 100, you don't have to worry about, you know, if you take an hour-long break, if someone else is going to pass you. That's something you have to worry about when you're just going for the 50 stones. That's why I say 50 easy stones. And I think this is probably going to be one of those World Tournaments that not a lot of people actually partake in, just because I don't think anybody wants to. Like, especially coming off of the 9-year anniversary, coming off Tanabata, we're looking forward to worldwide download. Do we really want to be spending our time doing this? I suppose maybe. I mean, I don't know. We'll see when we actually jump into World Tournament. The last World Tournament that we had was one of the most populated World Tournaments we've ever seen on Global. So maybe that trend will hold. We'll see. So let's just jump in here. We're going to take a look at the new characters, and then we'll talk about ranks. Actually, you know what? We'll start with the ranks, and we'll talk about the stones and how you can earn them. So from the top, let's start with the Dragonstone count. I am using an older World Tournament. Don't really look so much at the category missions and all that stuff. I just like using the original Dokkan Wiki layout. It's just easier to look at. These are massively out of date, though. But for the 50 Dragonstones, how do you earn them? Here we go. Daily missions, you have 3 stones that can be earned on the daily. So for global players, I am primarily doing this through the lens of the global players. Since we have 3 days to do the World Tournament, 3 Dragonstones times 3 is 9. So we're going to start with number 9. 9 plus 1 here, that's 10. Then we've got 11, 13. Okay, 13 Dragonstones. 14, 15, 16, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30, 33. Okay, 33, 34, 35, 40, 45, 46, 47, 48, and 50. So there you go. That is how you can earn all 50 Dragonstones. This is from a combination of different things. Doing the 3 wins per day is obviously bare minimum. Advancing to the semifinals just has to happen once. You will do this very easily. Winning amount of World Tournaments in a row, the most you got to do to get the stones is 7. But I would advise you try to go as far as you can, 20 in a row. But again, if you're not racing against anybody, there's far less room for error. So achieving 20 World Tournament wins in a row, while it may be slow, is still very achievable. For your score, the more points you log in, the more runs you do, the more points you get. In terms of the Dragonstones, the highest you want to be scoring is 23 million points. You should go for 30 so you can get the most amount of rewards here. For tiers, this is very easy. If you just start right at the jump at 30 times multiplier, you'll get to Beerus tier in no time. So that's easy points, easy Dragonstones. Wins, you'd have to win at most 8 wins to get the Dragonstones, but you should go for the 20 so you can get the extra characters. It's not going to be these characters again. Like I said, I'm looking at an older one. And then the local bracket does also give you some stones in the top 10 local, but that doesn't apply to most people, so I never count these. So actually, you can earn more than 50. It could be 51 all the way to 57 if you do those. And then these, I've never seen anyone actually get this. If you're someone who's had any of these rewards, let me know in the comments. A rank of 3 repeated digits, so like 333 or 5555 or 88888. Let me know if you're one of those, because I've never seen this before. Anyway, that is it for the Dragonstone count. Now let's take a look at the rankings and how you want to be looking at these ranks. So for the 52nd World Tournament for us, JP54, in general, you want to be trying to go for, I think it was roughly like 2000 if you want to be able to awaken all 4 of the new characters. That's the new thing with World Tournaments these days. They give you characters that are receiving EZAs. For this class of World Tournament, we have 1, 2, 3. We have only 3 characters receiving EZAs. So that actually lowers the workload quite a bit, because instead of going for 4, you're only going for 3. There's a new summonable character on the World Tournament banner, but then there are only 3 EZAs. In order to EZA the World Tournament characters, you need those tournament announcer medals, and those tournament announcer medals are handed to you in a large quantity depending on your global rank. You can also earn it in other ways, but in terms of global ranking, you can pretty much take care of all of the responsibility just by ranking high enough. So here are some numbers for you. If you rank in the top 2,000 globally, then you will earn enough medals to ECA 4 TURs. Normally, it's been 4 TURs. This time, they've decided to make it 3, so this doesn't quite apply here. So let me remove the all. If you want to ECA 4 TURs, you got to go into the top 2,000. If you rank into the top 50,000, that gives you enough medals to ECA 3 TURs. So let's see how many medals we need. It's 12, 20, 12, 12, right? No, 15, 40, 30, 30. Okay, so if we are to rank in the top 50,000 here, what the? We rank in the top 50,000 right there, then we will earn, there you go, 45, 120, 90, 90. So that's 15, 40, 30, 30 times 3. So that's perfect. That's the target rank if you want to ECA the 3 TURs just from this. If you rank in the top 200,000, then you will earn enough to ECA 2 TURs. Maybe you don't necessarily care about the Cyborg Tau. Maybe you don't have the character. Maybe you don't necessarily want to run the character on a team because you just don't care. Maybe it's just all about the two supports. This is a super class support. This is an extreme class support. Both these units are pretty good. This guy is the best. Actually, all three of them are pretty good, but this guy's definitely the best. So maybe you just want these two. So that means you only have to rank in the top 200,000 globally. If you rank in the top 400,000, then you will be able to ECA 1 TUR because that is how much you will get from the rewards. But on top of that, you can earn those World Tournament Announcer medals in other ways. In your local rankings, you will also earn these Hercule signatures. The Hercule signatures are what allow you to buy LR ECA medals as well as other things. Let me actually pull up the shop here. So Hercule signatures. Yeah, so you can buy like the Tien Chaozu medals, the Piccolo medals. Since then, obviously the Yamcha Puar LR is also there. So those medals are purchasable, as well as the World Tournament Announcers. These can be bought separately, and there's also one bundle where you can buy a full amount to Rainbow or to ECA TUR at 100. So there are a multitude of different things that you can buy here. Also, they are slowly but surely adding older characters that have since received ECAs. They are slowly being added into the Baba Shop. It used to be that they were being added the same time that they're getting their ECAs, but I guess they've changed it. They want to slow it down a little bit. So these units are going to be older ECAs, still somewhat relevant, but it's free to play. So you kind of have to take that with a grain of salt. There are other things you can buy here, but these I wouldn't advise you actually use your Hercule signatures on. It's really just about the medals and the LR ECA medals. So if we look at the breakdown for these, you can earn up to 90 Hercule signatures if you rank in the local bracket 1 to 3. Local rankings is just a subset of the gaming population. So it's just a random subset of characters or players, I should say. If you are randomly placed into a bracket with a tryhard, that's just the luck of the draw. That's all it is. So if you're not able to hit local rank 1, you will still get local rank 2 or 3, giving you the same 90 Hercule signatures. You can get 70 from ranks 4 through 10. You can get 60 from ranks 11 through 20. You can also earn 60 of them from World Tournament missions, and then 9 total from 3 days worth of daily missions. Meaning, if you are local rank 1 to 3 and you do everything else that I listed here, you can get almost 160 Hercule signatures, or 140 if you're ranked 4 through 10, or almost 130 if you're ranked 11 through 20. You need 115 of these Hercule signatures to buy enough medals to ECA 1 TUR, or you just need 100 of the Hercule signatures if you decide to just buy this bundle. This is available once per World Tournament, so that is a very nice option. You need a total of 135 of these Hercule signatures to ECA 1 LR. Let's just say you've been eyeing the LR Piccolo ECA. You need 45 of these medals. Each medal costs you 3 Hercule signatures. That's why you need 135 total. You don't have to buy all these in one go. If you buy half of it now and you want to use the rest of your Hercule signatures for something else, you can do that. You can buy the other half in the future. But over time, more LRs will be receiving LR ECAs. So it's better to try to get all of these done sooner. But it really just depends on what sort of a box you have, what sort of teams you want, what sort of characters you're eyeing. So if you don't care, it really doesn't matter. 100, yeah, so this is the 100 for the special pack, and that's it. So little factoid here, if you rank as low as the top 20 local, which is not the most difficult thing to do, and you complete all missions, just in general, you will earn enough to ECA 1 TUR. So let's just say you don't care about any of these guys except for Cell. You've been trying to put together a good artificial lifeform team, a good Android Cell Saga Extreme team, whatever the case may be. You just want this guy. If you want the one ECA, you just have to do something like this, and you will be able to accomplish just that. So those are some of the little info stats that I wanted to share with you guys in regards to the World Tournament, in regards to the rankings. I think in general, 200,000. I will be honest with you, since I am a World Tournament tryhard, I don't have a real understanding of what it's like to do the 200,000 World Tournament grind. But I would imagine that it's going to be far, far less taxing than something like a 2,000 grind. I do say occasionally that 2,000 is easy, which I will admit that is not entirely the most objective statement because I am biased. So I would say 200,000 is a pretty lenient target to go for. So I think in general, you guys should try to go for something like that, but it's all up to you in terms of your availability, in terms of your willingness to do this. I hate this event with a passion. So, you know, if you want to do it, then do it. But if you don't want to, hey, it'll make it easier for tryhards like me. So I appreciate that. So now let's go over the upcoming World Tournament ECAs, the new characters and whatnot. We'll just quickly repeat this like I did before. So this is the new Yamcha. This is going to be summonable on the World Tournament ticket banner, the same banner where you can get the Shen, the Teen Goku, the Demon King Piccolo, those types of characters. So this is basically like the Dragon Ball Saga banner. You have to get those tickets from World Tournament to actually summon on this. You can't just use stones. Not possible. Super Tech, 70%. Nobody cares. This guy raises attack and defense for one turn, causes supreme damage with a medium chance to stun. Attack and defense plus 150, medium chance to dodge, including super attack. Medium chance to crit, plus an additional attack and defense plus 20% per tournament participants, category ally, self excluded on the team, up to 100%. Plus an additional attack and defense plus 100% when performing a super attack per world tournament category ally, self excluded, attacking in the same turn, which is kind of nuts. It seems crazy, but remember, it's a world tournament category. Those generally aren't that busted. Although, that's not as true anymore with characters like World Tournament Goku, Majunior, and all that. The category is on the rise. But still, most of the World Tournament characters are free to play, so they are kind of scaled down. P plus 2 plus an additional dodge chance plus 10% per Turtle School category ally on the team, self-excluded. Plus an additional attack plus 100% and chance to crit plus 50 with HP being 86% or less. So this guy is just at his SSR form right now. After a couple more World Tournaments, he will receive a Dokkan Awakening, probably like 3 or 4 more World Tournaments. And we will see what the unit is like then. Obviously, he will be better. So this is not exactly a must-have right now, unless, of course, you really want that Dragon Ball Saga team and all the different components. So that's the new guy. Then the TUR EZAs. Let's start with probably the least available one for most of you, which is the Cyborg Tau. This guy's a 100% tech lead, greatly raises attack and raises defense for one turn, causes supreme damage with a great chance to stun. This is actually a pretty decent passive. Attack and defense plus 200%, attacks guaranteed to hit when performing a super. When an enemy is hit by this character's super attack, reduce damage received from that enemy by 50% for the duration of the turn. Very nice. P plus 1 up to 4, attack and defense plus 50 up to 200 with each attack received, which is good because you will likely do these two things first, launching a super and have your enhanced damage reduction. P plus 1, attack and defense plus 100% when there's an Earthlings or Tournament Participants category enemy. That very much applies to some of the more recent Tournament of Power style Blue Zone events, so you could bring this unit into that. Performs a critical hit when there is a Turtle School category enemy. So this is actually a very nice set of skills to bring against the UI Goku on the UI Goku Blue Zone event. So he could actually be pretty good for that. So there's your Cyborg Tau. In terms of best linking buddies, yeah. Yeah, there you go. So all Dragon Ball Saga.
Okay.
Next, we've got the two Super Class Extreme Class supports. I like these two characters. Sadly, the Gohan is inferior to the Cell. 100% lead for STR, greatly raises attack and defense for one turn, causes supreme damage, and lowers attack and defense. Key plus 3, attack and defense plus 180, plus an additional attack and defense plus 20%, with each attack performed up to 58. Superclass allies, key plus 3, attack and defense plus 30%, plus an additional attack and defense plus 10% for characters who belong to Defenders of Justice or Tournament Participants category. Plus an additional attack and defense plus 58% when there is an Extreme Class enemy. Extreme Class enemies, attack minus 20%, defense minus 58%, launches an additional super attack when facing only one enemy. Guards all attacks when facing two or more enemies. So this is a crowd control character, meaning when you're fighting multiple opponents, you have your guard up and you're obviously a lot more resilient. You can also nerf the enemy. So nerfing the enemy while raising your own stats and while boasting guard does create sort of a makeshift damage reduction effect. So this is still useful on certain situations, but in general, it's the 1v1s that we care about because the challenge events really cater to the 1v1 setup a little bit more. So That is what the Super Saiyan 2 Saiyaman is capable of. He is a very differently named character. So in terms of fitting this unit onto a bunch of different teams, it's going to be fairly easy. This is a Majin Buu Saga character, another nice free-to-play unit for the Majin Buu Saga category. So still a great character overall. Then we get to the Cell. Perfect Form Cell. Massively raises attack and defense for one turn, causes supreme damage. No nerfing here, just 100% stat boost for attack and defense temporarily. He's a 100% tech lead. Attack and defense plus 200%. Extreme class allies key plus 3. Attack and defense plus 30%. Plus an additional attack and defense plus 10% for characters who belong to artificial lifeforms or tournament participant categories. Plus an additional attack and defense plus 100% when attacking if there's a superclass enemy, so blue zone. Superclass enemies attack minus 20%, defense minus 60%. Reduces damage received by 30% when facing only one enemy. Launches an additional super attack when facing two or more enemies. So I personally prefer builds like this where it caters more to the 1v1 and then there's sort of a fallback for the other situations. So this guy's going to do well on blue zone challenge events, 1v1 situations. And, you know, this unit also has big bad bosses. So you combine big bad bosses with nerfing the enemy with the extra stats when fighting a super class plus 30% damage reduction with hopefully multiple supers. This is a pretty stacked free-to-play support unit. So let me know in the comments what you guys think about these various EZAs. In a nutshell, I think that these two characters are worth pursuing. So if you need the medals to EZA both of these, assuming you're starting from scratch, then going for the top 200,000 rank, I think would be the best way to get the most that you can out of the World Tournament. But if you don't want to do any of that, at the very least, do the missions so that you can get all 50 Dragonstones so that you can get ready for the worldwide download celebration. Because after all, in the end, that is the most important thing. Leave the tryharding to the sweats. Let them do their thing. You can take it easy this World Tournament because we got some hype summons coming up in 2 weeks. Actually, for Global, 1 week. But honestly, 2 weeks. You shouldn't be summoning for Jiren anyway. 2 weeks. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like down below. Love the comments. What are your plans for this weekend, both IRL and in terms of World Tournament? Are you going to be doing the World Tournament? If so, how hard are you going to be going? What is your target rank? What is your target EZA thing? Are you going to go for 1, 2, all 3 EZAs? Let me know your goals in the comments down below. Also, be sure to subscribe for more dope content in the future and click the notification bell so that you let YouTube know you want to see more of my stuff. Do it. Thanks again. Stay tuned and Arjun Reds of Dokkan responsibly.